The Diocese of Greensburg was recently a stop on a nationwide relic pilgrimage. The incorrupt heart of St. John Vianney was brought here in April. An incorrupt body of a saint is one that has not decomposed after their death. Many came to venerate this relic. So what are relics, and why do Catholics venerate them? I was able to learn a lot about them by visiting St. Anthony Chapel in Troy Hill, where more than 5,000 relics are housed right here in western Pennsylvania. It is the largest collection of relics on public display in the world outside of the Vatican. A first-class relic is the remains of a saint's body, or anything that came in contact with Jesus. A second-class relic is something that belonged to a saint, such as a piece of clothing or a possession. And a third-class relic is something that has touched a first- or second-class relic. I was able to see a thorn from Jesus' crown of thorns, and one reliquary held a piece of bone from each of the apostles and a piece of the true cross. In another case was a piece of Mary's veil. It is important to understand that relics and saints are not worshipped. Only God is worshipped. The saints were holy men and women who led exemplary lives. Catholics look to the saints for prayers and support, just as you would ask a friend.
The reliquary here that I have in my hand was made in Aachen in 1880. Father Subert Mullinger, who was the founder of St. Anthony's Chapel, had it crafted. Within the very center of this reliquary lies a particle of the true cross, the cross on which our Lord died for us on Good Friday. Surrounding it are many relics of the different saints within our faith. Father Subert Mullinger also was known as a priest, physician, healer. People traveled from everywhere, even from across the country, to come and see him so that he could help them with their spiritual or physical ills. Many times, Father would bestow a blessing on the person with one of the relics of the saints that he had acquired. Many times, the blessing turned into a healing through the intercession of the saint's relic who Father had blessed them with.
Many claimed to be healed and left behind their canes and crutches as a testament of their healing. This summer, take some time to learn about the saints. You may be inspired to make the trip to St. Anthony Chapel, see the relics, and invite your favorite saints to pray for you on your journey of faith. I'm Mary Siemens on assignment, Discovering Relics.